After creating a new Spring Boot project and importing it to your workspace using your preferred IDE, now let's do the configuration part. The configuration is really quite simple and easy. All we need to do is just to go to the SRC main and resources, and we need to edit or add some properties in the application.properties file. So what we need to do is that we need to add the data source URL, username and password. And also we need to provide the driver class name. So like this, when you start the application, Spring Boot will automatically manage the database connection. Here we need to provide the or to specify the database management system. In our case, it's MySQL, and we can choose whether to show or hide the SQL queries. Now, in my case, I always hide them because it's going to be a lot of logs or a lot of console output. For example, why I add this configuration here? For example, by default, Spring will start up using the 8080 port. Use this port. So if this port is already in use, here we can override or choose another port using this property, which is server.port equals the new port we want to use. And here in this part is the Hibernate DDL auto. We have three options, which is create and drop and update. And now I will explain to you which each property. So the property is spring.gpa.hibernate DDL auto. Here we have the create. So every time we start up the application, Spring will create or hibernate will create a new database or a new schema. So what will Spring do is will erase or remove the database and create a new one. So we will override it every time. So in case we keep it as create, here there is a really big risk of losing data once we restart the application. We have also the create drop. So the create drop is will create the database at the application startup, and when we shut down the application, Spring will automatically drop the database. So these two properties or these two values, I recommend to use them in the really early phase of development, which is we just in the phase of creating the entities and creating the database, and we are doing some updates, for example, adding new fields, removing new fields, so we can use those two values. And the best one or the most recommended one is the update. The update, it will create the database if it doesn't exist at the startup. And every time we add a new field, so it will be automatically added also to the dedicated or to the correspondent table. One thing regarding the update, if we remove a field, it's not gonna be removed from the database. So if, for example, if we're still in the first or in the first phase of development, we can just make it create and restart the application and then update it, put it back to update. Or if, for example, we after, I don't know, 6 or 7 months, we want to do some update and remove some fields, it's better to do it using an SQL query. And here we specify the dialect. So like this, or using this property, Spring and Hibernate will know which dialect is preferred or they need to use. For example, is here we are using MySQL, so it's gonna be the MySQL 5 dialect. Now, let me explain to you those parts, and especially this one, the URL or the connection string. So here to connect to our database is is on our local machine using the port 3306, and to connect it, just we can use gdbc /mysql /localhost 3306, or the port if you change another one. And then we specify the database name. Here we want our database to be automatically created if it doesn't exist. So we don't need to create the database manually before starting the application. So all we need to do is create, add this create database if not exist equal true. And here this use user SSL false and the Unicode and so on and so forth is just to avoid all kinds of problems while connecting to the database, and also using the legacy datetime code and so on and so forth. So, and here we have the username, which is by default root for MySQL databases. If you do not provide, or if you do not choose a password at the startup or at the installation or the setup of MySQL, so you keep it empty. If you choose another password, for example, root, you can just make it root. So once you finish this configuration, once you finish this configuration, all you need is to start the application, and Spring will automatically create the database and create all the tables and all the relations, the cardinalities, and so on and so forth. So this is all about configuring the project.